Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you the basic configuration of the controller. So the first step is going to the main folder of the asset, go to prefabs and player controller. Locate GTC prefab, select it, drag and drop in the hierarchy. So now as you can see, the object is placed in the position 000. You need to be sure that the position is that when the game is played, because in other case the HUD is displaced in the scene as you can see, so make sure of that. Now what you can do is select player controller and player camera and place it in the position that you need, for example here, and now you can play the scene. So the player is ready to make any action of the asset, like shoot, jump, chain gravity, etc. Now, what if you want to change the default model for your own? You only need to select the Ethan Gain object inside Gravity Center and delete it. Now select your model. I'm going to use this from the asset store and make sure that in the rig options the animation type is humanoid to work properly with the mechanic. So drop it here, go to character and press the build player button. Now as you can see, different game objects are being placed inside the skeleton model. Now you have these two cubes that are used to place every hand of the player when he is aiming. So the left is going to be here and the right is here. Every position is independent. So you can place the left here and the right, for example, here. Another thing that you have to check is the spine game object, which is rotated when the player is aiming. So here the set the local and pivot option to see the current local direction of the axis. As you can see, the set axis is the one that is going to be used to rotate the spine. So go here, spike vector, and make sure that is 1 or minus 1 according to the direction of the rotation. For example, place the game, press the aim button and you can see that his spine is rotated accordingly to the camera rotation. But if 1 is placed here, his spine is rotating incorrectly. So for every model this will need a different valve. Also you can notice that his hands are not rotating correctly. So select these objects and rotate it like that. Like I said, every model is different, so every model will need a different rotation for every hand. But it's very simple to do. Now as you can see, he can do any action like the default model. Also, if the player dies right now, for example with the test button, an animation is played. And if you play again button, he get up. But it's using animations. If you want to use Ragdoll, you need to go to the Ragdoll builder, and as you can see, the Ragdoll has not been added. So press the build Ragdoll button, and as you can see, there are colliders and rigid bodies inside his body. If any collider is bigger than you need, you can edit by selecting every object, for example pelvis, and you can edit it one by one. Also, you can, if you don't want to use the procedural ragdoll, you can go to the given object option and select ragdoll. So you need to drag every bone inside the inspector. Now, if you play the game and the model dies, now it uses ragdoll. Again, if you want to use animations instead of rigidbody, you only need to go to ragdoll activator and select change the type of death, mechanic or ragdoll. For example, mechanic. An animation is used instead of the ragdoll. So you can use it as you want. So this is all for now. In next videos, I'm going to show you every component of every important game object and how to configure them. For example, plane controller, chain gravity, other powers, etc. All of them one by one. See you.